been much worse, but for some fire breaks made last week.
It's still unknown how the fire started just before 7:30 last night, but once it took hold, the billowing smoke could be seen from miles away. Hundreds of spectators started to congest Main North Road as 13 pumpers and 44 firefighters attacked the massive inferno. But if Salisbury Fire Station hadn't taken precautions last week, the blaze would have been four times as big. The company, Enviro Waste, decided to split the 10,000 tyres into four stacks to make fire breaks. The Bylow warehouse next door is still standing because only one of the stacks caught on fire. But it still took 2 hours for firefighters to control the blaze.
I actually witnessed some of the firefighters trying to pull tyres and literally pulling tyres away from the stack. And I was standing probably 50 to 60 metres away and I was perspiring. I was very hot and they were actually only two or three metres away rolling tyres out.
I believe they were talking a temperature in excess of 1,000 degrees Celsius. I was there with the troops and I experienced that extreme heat. We're very aware of the heat stress on our firefighters and managed to change them over every 10 minutes.
The fire was still smouldering this morning, while some buildings in the area suffered
worse.
Huge clouds of smoke filled the skies over Para Hills and surrounding areas last night. Down below, firefighters were waging a losing battle. Thousands of tyres were ablaze. There were fears the fire would spread to adjoining shops, and it was more than 2 hours before the inferno was under control. But the situation could have been much worse. It's understood fire safety officers who visited the premises 2 weeks ago anticipated the potential fire threat and instructed the owner to split the large stack of tyres into three separate piles. Fire officers say had that not happened, the adjoining Bylow megastore would have been destroyed by the fire. Extra MFS units were called to the scene, and at the height of the blaze, nearby residents were warned to stay inside their homes. Fire officers still don't know exactly what caused the blaze. Deanna Cronin, National 9 News.